Water is cool. It's fun to swim in it. It's what we drink. And all life on Earth depends on water. Let's take a look at the different forms water can take. When we think of water, we usually think of water in its liquid form. This might be because more than two-thirds of the Earth's surface is covered in water. However, water has three states: solid, liquid, and gas, all of which occur naturally on Earth. Here are a list of the key terms we will go over in this video. Most of the time, we find water in its liquid state, the wet and fluid form of water that we are most familiar with. This is because the temperature is usually somewhere between 32 degrees Fahrenheit and 212 degrees Fahrenheit. At 32 degrees Fahrenheit, or 0 degrees Celsius, water becomes ice, a process known as freezing. When the temperature goes back above 32 degrees Fahrenheit, ice becomes liquid again, a process known as melting. Now, we know what happens to water when it gets cold, but what happens when water gets hot? At 212 degrees Fahrenheit, or 100 degrees Celsius, water becomes a gas. In its gas form, water is known as water vapor. This transition from liquid to gas is called evaporation. Just like the ice, water vapor can also transition back into liquid water. When water vapor cools down below 212 degrees Fahrenheit, it becomes liquid again, a process known as condensation. Let's follow the transition of water through the different temperatures one more time to summarize what we learned in this video. When water gets cold enough, it freezes and turns into ice. We can warm the ice back up so that it melts and becomes liquid again. When water gets very hot, it evaporates and turns into water vapor. If we cool the water vapor back down, it condensates and goes back from gas to liquid. These are the states of water. Until then, always be clever. Hey, hey.